Even using math, there's no practical way to predict where the next water drop will land. There's too many variables. However, say I couldn't see the sprinkler.
From the pattern of the drops, I could calculate its precise location.
It's not about predicting the next site. It's finding what the sites have in common, the point of origin.
Charlie, you're saying you can tell us where the killer lives?
Yeah. These guys follow patterns.
Exactly.
It's Monday. It's 2:45 in the afternoon. Monday after lunch.
Larry.
You have abilities. You could be helping define the nature of reality. All I'm asking is that you just consider how you spend what time you have.
I've pinpointed the area most likely to be the perpetrator's residence.
You got the guy's address?
Not the address, no. An approximate base.
In trying to avoid a pattern, you wound up with one anyway?
Yep, location's purposefully distanced from a site not on your map, but clearly marked in the perpetrator's mind, namely his residence. The equation reveals the probability that each area has of being the subject's base. Yellow's the hot zone.
I had a feeling about Silver Lake.
I estimate an 87% chance he lives in that area.
You know, I don't know a lot about mathematics, but this doesn't make any sense to me.
It makes more sense than this.
You can't win if you don't buy a ticket.
Yes, this is truth. However, the odds of this one being the winning ticket are 1 in 41 million, which means if you bought 20 tickets every week, you would win the jackpot once every 40,000 years.
Really?
Yep. It's basic probability theory.